Hello, everyone. We're back in winter. You know, we had a foot of snow and big drifts, and it all melted. And now we got, you know, I can show you here a little bit. I don't know what we got. 5-6 inches. Back to winter. And now they're saying it's going to warm up again, but I don't know if it's going to melt this time. So I am dropping off some parts, turn some light on, and was also going to tell you about the sponsor for this video is HISEA. HISEA boots, shoes, you name it. I did receive a pair of these work boots. They're excellent. I've been walking around just in the house with them. Of course, I'll be using them in this shop. We got a bunch of work to do on my combine. Not a bunch, but just regular maintenance, getting it ready for next year. But anyway, let's talk about these shoes. So HISEA was kind enough to send me another pair of boots. I requested work boots because I'll be using these in the summer, of course, and in the shop. These are steel toe. They are very, very well-made boots, and they're comfortable. So you can actually wear these for dress. My wife thought, you know, these would even be good for dress before I get them all dirty, but we'll see. And so, you know, I've been wearing these snow boots from HISEA right here. Got them on right now, all last season, all last winter, and this winter, and they're comfortable, no wear on them, good traction, and they're warm and dry. So HISEA does offer to all my followers 15% off on all their shoes, all their boots. And all you have to do is type in Diamond Heart at the discount code and you will get 15% off. HISEA actually offers a 100-year warranty, which they call their lifetime warranty because nobody's gonna live much longer than that wearing boots. anyway, but there is an exception to that, but they do have a 100-year warranty, which I don't know any other company that offers you a 100-year warranty on their shoes. So 15% off, 100-year warranty, you can't go wrong. So I put that radiator hose in here now. I think I should have just about all my parts for this combine. I have the feeder house chain sprockets. The feeder house chain is on its way, so we're going to be replacing that too. And then I got parts, of course, some bearings and endless parts. Not a bunch, but more to do on this combine while it's nice and warm in here. So there's not as much to do next spring, because you know how that is with calving and everything else, seeding, getting ready. Just the summer gets away on you. Here's them boots that I got last year. Here's the HISEA logo, and I'll put the description below and the links and all the code information, everything you need to get your shoes. But these are excellent. Like I said, I've had these now for, I think, over a year, and I love them. They're warm, and your feet are dry, and they're comfortable. So what else do you need? And there's a lot of traction. You don't slip around with the soles on these shoes. I'm wearing these boots now that I got from them. And they're good. Very good. So anyway, I got to go do chores. So you might as well come along with me and we'll go feed the cows. Huh. Mama's calling. Anyway, let's get these tractors started and I'll see what Mama wants. Hello. I'm here at the ground hay now. You can see that. We got that hay ground last week. I've been feeding now for about a week. And which has been, you know, I think it's is it the 12th of December? It's it's really good to not have to start feeding until you get into December. So that's good for us. Of course, we did feed that first snowstorm that melted. We had a feed there for a while because we had lots of it. You've seen on my videos all the snow we had. And we got snow now again, but not as much as the first time. But, you know, they kind of picked through everything and it's time to start feeding. You know, really, we're only, what are we, middle of March calving. That isn't that far away, so I don't know. We'll just start feeding and making sure they got everything they need to grow that calf inside them, keep them healthy. You can do that a number of ways. I know people say you don't have to feed if you got a lot of grazing to do, just supplement them with, you know, their, what they need, their minerals, and that works. But everybody's different, every situation is different, so we are starting to feed. So anyhow, so we're gonna just keep going here and load that feed wagon with hay, silage, and I am feeding some straw. Of course, I'm gonna put a little straw in just because it is still December. Maybe we get into mid-January and then I'll quit the straw, but this way it'll make our hay last a little longer. So now I'm going after a little silage. I alternate, you know, chopped hay. Oh, I just dumped in some straw, but I alternate, you know, the dry hay and silage until I get my load where I want it. Yesterday I did clean this all up with the payloader. That's why it looks the way it does here, pushed up, but just kind of getting ready now to start feeding for the year. Get a good open pile. I just opened this a week ago, so just trying to get it set up for the winter, get it opened up nice and clean. And I think Blue, he approves. I don't know what he's looking for, but my dog, he's on top of the pile. Anyway, let's dump her in. Well, continue to load that wagon. Now that I got the wagon fully loaded with feed, going to the final step, and that's liquid feed. That's where they're getting all their, you know, all their minerals they need. Some fat, some protein. So I'm gonna put that in, and then this load will be ready. I normally feed around 8,000 pounds a day now, which translates to about 35 pounds per cow of feed. And the reason I'm doing that is because, you know, we got enough snow that everything is covered. There is some grazing, some picking they can do, and we're hoping that it melts some, because we are going to have 2 weeks of nice weather again. You know, nice weather is, you're talking around 40, high 30s, but that's only a few hours a day, so there's not going to be a whole lot of melting, but we'll take it. You know, we'll take it. That warmer weather, you know, they don't need as much feed. I'm trying to get lined up here. As much feed to keep them warm, keep them happy. So I'm gonna go put some liquid feed in now, and then we'll go unload it. Okay, so I'm set up here with the tank, or with the trailer, and I'm gonna throw the switch on. Watch her come out. So on this here, you can feed, you know, I don't know, up to 3 pounds per head, which is a lot. So I'm feeding about 1.5 pounds per head. Watching my scale until I get right where I want it, which is there. And I'll let her mix while we go out to unload this. It'll just keep running like it is. See the PTO shaft turning? So we'll go out and feed these girls. Like I said, they're getting about 35 pounds per head per day. And that'll increase as winter goes on and as they get closer to calving. But for now, it's going to be 35. And you guys can do the math. You know about how many cows we got then. So we did sell, we sold 44 cows. After we PG'd, we had some open ones and some older ones. And you know, you always got a couple problem cows that you get rid of. We just cleaned out 44 head. So we're going to have a few less cows to calve this spring. Although I did keep 30, I don't know, over 30 heifers, 32, 33 yearlings, so they'll be bred. But like I said, when they calve, you know, that'll be a year from now, or a year and a half from now, and by then we'll have more cows to sell. So we're just maintaining our herd. That's our goal here, is just maintain the herd numbers, and I did bring my drone along today. I'll try to get some drone footage. It'll be just when after I'm done feeding. I got to go back and get just a part of a load yet to get up to 8,000 pounds total. I could put all 8,000 on this wagon behind me, but it's a load. It spills out, makes a mess, so I don't. All the cows are coming, so what I'm going to do is shift down into letter A, which is the slowest speed, toggle down to first gear. I'll rev it back up now. I don't know why I revved it down. And then we'll unload the feed here. The cows are coming, walking over here. So we're gonna give them their ration for the day. Actually going to toggle up a couple gears here, get her in third. But here they come. Okay, so I finished doing chores. And as promised, I'm going to get my drone up and fly it around here, show you my calves in the corral and the heifers and the few light ones that we kept back and the cows. But before I do, I don't know if I mentioned it, that I will send a link in the description of these HISEA boots that I received, and probably the ones I'm wearing, the winter boots, which are great, and the discount code. I will also put that in the description. You know, these boots are, they're very well made. All the winter boots that I'm wearing and these work boots. And I can tell you, you guys know the leading boot manufacturers that you probably would normally buy from, maybe, I don't know. These are half the price, all these boots. And the quality is just as good or better. So anyway, let's get this drone up, and thanks again for watching. See you later.